inside the Russia's Kremlin. You might be wondering why it is called the Kremlin when it could have been simply referred to as the Russia's house or seat of power. But there seems to be a solid historical backup for this name, and I am pretty sure you would be interested in gaining some insightful facts about where Vladimir Putin lays his head after a tough day at work. Please endeavor to subscribe to this channel and watch this video till the end. The word Kremlin dates back as far as 1320 and was derived from the term Kremlinology, meaning the study of Soviet and Russia politics, so it was officially adopted as the name. Before now, this edifice, known today as the Kremlin, was initially called the Grad of Moscow in the 14th century. Though the initial walls of the Kremlin were oak walls, they were converted to white limestone between 1366 and 1368 by Dmitry Donskoy. But the wall as it appears today was designed by Petrus Antonius Salariums between 1485 and 1495. Grand Prince Ivan III was responsible for reconstructing the Kremlin walls and towers. He also engaged Marcus Rufus to construct his new palace during his reign as king. Three extant cathedrals of the Kremlin, the Deposition Church, and the Palace of Facets were constructed. Now that we have been through a little bit of history class, let's discuss and describe the Kremlin properly. The Kremlin wall is shaped like an irregular triangle and surrounds a massive 275,000 square meters, 2,960,000 square feet area of land. Its height is about 5 to 19 meters, 16 to 62 feet, having a wall density of between 3.5 and 6.5 meters, 11 and 21 feet. These walls used to have 18 defensive towers, but today they are 20 in numbers, with each reaching a height of 20 to 21 feet. Though the highest of these towers is Troitskaya, built in 1495, while the tower serving as the entrance is known as the Trinity Tower. The Kremlin is known to house treasures worth over $1 billion, and one amazing fact about this great monumental structure is that it has a lot of secret underground tunnels and chambers. And it is known to accommodate numerous massive buildings, some of which are the Cathedral Square, the Cathedral of the Annunciation, Cathedral of the Archangel Michael, Ivan the Great Bell Tower, Ivan III's Palace of Facets, the Grand Kremlin Palace, the Arsenal, the Armory Building, and some others. Presently, the Kremlin houses the Senate building and is also the residential place of Russia's presidents, starting from Boris Yeltsin, the first president of Russia in 1991. It is always open to visitation from tourists, apart from some secret places. Inside the Kremlin, to the northern corner is the arsenal, constructed in 1701 for Peter the Great. Ancient weapons of different calibers worth billions are stored here. The Armory Building, built in 1851, presently serves as a museum containing Russia's state regalia and diamond funds, the famous double-sided throne belonging to Ivan V and Peter Chapter 1, containing a secret chamber for the king's advisors, the great imperial throne having 5,000 gems and 2,500 carat gold embroidered on it is kept here too. And it was worth $52 million as at 1920. Who knows how much it will be worth now? The Cathedral Square, which is regarded as the heart of the Kremlin, has a 16 meters underground compartment. Though it is the newest building in this complex, it was constructed in 1961. Another monumental edifice is the Ivan Great Bell Tower, located at the northeast corner of the square. It is 81 meters, 266 feet, high and serves as a museum and houses the largest known bell in the world, the 16th century Tsar Bell, as well as the famous 14th century Tsar Cannon. The State Kremlin Palace has over 800 rooms, while the Grand Kremlin Palace, which is 124 meters long, 47 meters high and 25,000 square two-stories building, is the largest Kremlin complex and structure, costing 11 million rubies and renovated in 1990s with $1 billion. It was first commissioned by Nicholas III in 1838. This structure has ceremonial red carpet staircase and halls like the St. Vladimir's Hall, having skylight and chandeliers, St. Gregory's Hall, which is the largest hall containing six giant chandeliers and displaying floors made of 20 different types of wood, St. Catherine's Hall, which contains the throne of the Empress, ornaments, thin candle lightning and chandelier. She was the first female Audley, St. Andrew's and St. Alexander Halls have golden doors leading to them, and inside contains highly decorated ceilings and floor resembling wooden carpets. This structure creates a link between the Ivan III's Palace of Facets and the Tarim Palace. The Ivan III's Palace of Facets is the oldest standing building in the Kremlin, and the second oldest is the Tarim Palace, which is the royal family's first home. This family is known to worth about $250-300 billion, and their first home has a waiting room, a throne room containing red chairs, and an underground library which was discovered. There is also an underground storeroom and cell, garment creation room, and the personal room of the Tsars. A secret treasure room and passage leading to the Cathedral of Annunciation was also discovered. Contained in the Cathedral of Annunciation is also a golden reception hall built in 1490 by Ivan III, containing discreet windows for the wife of Tsars to watch ceremonies. At one corner is also a corner leading to President Putin's private rooms. Putin is estimated to worth $70 billion. Just recently, President Putin gave order for a Kremlin helipad to be constructed so as to bypass the heavy traffic congestion. It was completed in May 2013. I am sure you enjoyed every bit of this video. Ensure you hit the subscription and notification button to always get access to our new videos. Your likes and comments are also appreciated. Thank you for watching.